Hello, my rock and roll friends. We're going to get started with one of those bad boys right there. So, tis the buying season. We're in the Thanksgiving, Black Friday, Cyber Monday time of year. And I have this box over here behind me from Sweetwater. So, this is heavier than I thought it was going to be. So in here we have a guitar, and this is one of their Black Friday blowout guitars. And there's a story behind this guitar. I think everyone that tunes in regularly knows I always have a story behind every guitar I buy. And I want to share with you the story on this guitar, okay? But before we dig in, I would really like to share with you my experience of purchasing a guitar from Sweetwater, okay? I don't think I ever did a video on this. You know, a lot of times I just get a guitar and pop it open and, you know, poof, here it is, right? But I figured, you know what, let's get the camera rolling today and, you know, mix it up a little bit. And first and foremost, let's see. This actually has a pretty interesting sticker on here. So if you do get a guitar, and it's actually very smart that they put that on there. So you have this caution sticker, and let me read it to you. So in case the camera's not picking it up, it says, Sweetwater, caution, read this before opening. We realize you really want to open this box and start playing your new instrument, but we strongly recommend you wait 24 hours before doing so. Sudden and drastic changes in temperature or climate can potentially damage the clear coat, finish, paint, and even the wood itself, which could also impact the playability and functionality of your instrument. Waiting 24 hours before opening this box will allow the instrument to slowly adjust to your home, facility temperature, and climate, and will help avoid any related issues. This is particularly important during the winter months when climates are quite different across the country. We know it's hard to wait, but please trust us on this one. Your friends, Sweetwater Guitar Gallery. That's actually brilliant that they put that there, because that's something I do anyway. Anytime I get a guitar, especially in the, you know, extreme temperatures, the middle of the summer, the middle of the winter, I always, when I receive a box, I bring it inside and I leave it for a day. Always. Because, you know, and you see this a lot where, you know, you have like these clear coat finish cracks, and because, you know, wood expands and contracts, right? That's why sometimes it's sharp and flat depending on the time of the year. And paint isn't so flexible. So sometimes you get finish cracks, or you could get this spider type of crack throughout the paint. I've never had anything severe or drastic occur like that, but it can happen. And that's why I always just, you know, I'm more conservative with stuff, and I usually wait the day, but I like the sticker. I think that's important. Okay, with that said, that was a lot of words to cover a sticker. Anyway, let's jump into this. Now, normally I would do this standing up, but I'm trying to keep this in frame, so bear with the awkward nature. I wouldn't normally open a guitar sitting down like this and all that, but I'm trying to be in the frame to share it with you all. So they have their Sweetwater tape, which you could see here. My dog barking upstairs, which you could hear. Ah, okay. We'll have to tag it. Happy New Gear Day with the pound symbol. Am I showing my age? That, you know, that used to be called the pound symbol before it was a hashtag. I'm just saying. Just saying. All right, what else do we have in here? Thank you. We got a nice little thank you thing from Mr. Surak. And this is nice. Let's see what we have. We have my invoice. Throw that over there. And the Sweetwater Difference. If you want to pause the camera and check out the Sweetwater Difference, there it is right there. And if you want to pause the camera, and there it is right there. Okay. Bullet points here. They have advice, free 2-year warranty, fast free shipping, online resources, free tech support. Save all the packaging, check your order. What if there's a problem? What if it's defective? You know, they give you recourse for pretty much everything, which is very smart. It also shows they care. Okay. Returns and exchanges, no hassle return policy. They definitely do it right. Look at this, double checked and packed by. There's a signature at the bottom. Very, very, very smart. All right, so what do we have in here? We have this expander foam, which is actually really nice. This is the good stuff here. So let me throw that over there. And, never saw one of those on this channel, the D'Angelico. I got a D'Angelico. Okay, so let's, now I'm gonna stand up and kinda heave-ho this thing out of this gigantic box. So bear with me for a second. Actually, there's no way I'm gonna do that. Let me slide it out of the side. I almost need someone to hold the other end for me. Maybe I could do this. Actually, some nice bubble wrap, which I always save for when I sell a guitar. Okay, and wow, there's even more stuff in here. Hang on. A phone book, literally. This catalog is as big as a phone book. Let me throw that over there, and more of that expander foam in the bottom, which helps for impact. Now, what's interesting here, oh, and my candy. Hang on. Here is my candy. That was a sweet way of saying thank you. And I got some cherry taffy and Tootsie Rolls, and I guess those are Red Hots. Oh, I love the banana. And oh, I love a bit of honey too. Would you mind if I had a bit of honey while we do this? One in Rome, guys, right? Bit of honey. This is like one of these classic candies. I'm telling you, it's just, when you have one, you wish you had more. I love a bit of honey. What a good way to do the review, talking, you know, food in my mouth. Okay, so, I'm blaming that this on Sweetwater. Okay. So, this is what's interesting. A lot of companies, because I bought a lot of guitars, will ship their guitars just like this in a factory box. Sweetwater double boxed it. I give them a lot of credit for that. Because I'm sure this is fine. Now, I apologize for eating. I had to have my bit of honey. So, let me segue for a moment. This is my opinion, okay? Just to be crystal clear, this is my opinion. This guitar was listed as like a factory second. And I've said this in past videos, which I will link to at the end of this video, in terms of how to buy a guitar. This was listed as a factory second. I don't believe that this was a factory second. I believe this is a brand new guitar that they are literally selling for half price. And you gotta really, as a consumer, you gotta keep your eyes open and look for the deals. Sweetwater has the deals, especially on this guitar here, which is why it's here. This was literally 50% off of street. I'm not talking ridiculous, like, you know, list prices and all that. This was 50% off of the street price, which is crazy. And it said, and I think the way companies in general or retailers in general get away with discounting it so low is by saying it's a second, it's a factory second, it's a blem. But when there's a lot of them, that's, to me, that's the cue of we need to let this go, maybe at cost or something like that, just because maybe they made too many and they need to let them go. End of the year is when they need to let them go. Factory seconds to me are ones that are stamped factory second, which you don't really see too many of those anymore. They used to be more common than they are, or when there's one or two, but not this many. And they have a lot of these. Okay, so clearly it's a D'Angelico, and I picked D'Angelico, reason number one. I don't own one. I don't own a D'Angelico. And that's like, you know, checkbox number one. Definitely not a duplicate because I don't own a D'Angelico. Now, when I pop this bad boy open, if you like me, you're going to be like, oh, that's so cool. So let's see how cool this is. Yeah, this is a factory sealed box. This is not a repack. This is a factory sealed box. Now, let me just be crystal clear on something, because somebody's going to put this in the comments. Sweetwater has their 55-point inspection, whatever their number is. When I ordered this, I told them, that's okay, we don't need to do that, okay? So, in case someone is saying, because I would be saying it as a viewer, I'd be saying, hey, wait a second, if this is sealed, why didn't they do their 55-point inspection? I'm just letting you know that the conversation I had with my peeps at Sweetwater, I said, it's okay not to do that. Just so we're clear and, you know, the comments don't light up on that. Anytime you're opening a box, be careful for the little metal things, okay? That'll give you a nice wrist scratch. Wow, more bubble wrap. Tell you what, this is packed like a beautifully. Can you see inside? I'm trying to give you the best view I could give you here. Hang on. Okay. And I'm gonna pull straight out. There we go. And that's it. And then there's more cardboard at the bottom. Okay, so what we have here is a nice, came with the guitar, nice branded case, D'Angelico New York, although I know this guitar is not made in New York. The company might be founded in New York or something like that, but the guitar is imported. Let's pop it open. A rumor on D'Angelico. I heard a rumor. I don't know if this is true. I heard a rumor that the owner of D'Angelico, maybe a silent owner, is the owner of Arizona Iced Tea. If somebody knows if that's true or not, leave it in the comment below. I'd be curious to know. But I did hear that, and you know, this is very conversational. I'm just popping it open. It popped in my head. I figured I'd ask you, but I don't know that for a fact, but I did hear that, so curious to know what you think. Okay, here we go. Huh? What? So, this here, let me back up so you could appreciate this guitar. Okay, so this is made in Indonesia. I know that because it's stamped on the back. Now, here's the story behind this guitar. But, by the way, let me look at it first. Let me take my glasses off. Still has the pick guard plastic on. Still has the pickup plastic on. There's plastic on here. I'll show you. These little things. You can't even see it. These little plastic things on the pickups. There isn't a fingerprint on this thing. There's no blems. I'm telling you, this is a brand new guitar. I've bought enough guitars to know when someone's selling a second, that's like secret code for, especially when there's a lot of them, they're just looking to blow them out. And that's how companies get around Matt. So, brand new guitar. I guarantee brand new guitar. Okay, so here's the story with this guitar. First question someone might say is, oh, dude, I didn't know you were a big Grateful Dead fan. Well, truth is, I'm not. I like the Grateful Dead, but I am far from a huge Grateful Dead fan. Like for easy music, listening music, think of Dave Matthews before Dave Matthews, right? That style, that jam band music. It's good background music for me. Never had a problem with Grateful Dead. Always enjoyed the music. But when I saw this guitar, you know, this is, there it is. You could see the flames in the red and the blue. It's a flame maple top. Basically, this is an ES-335, like a Gibson ES-335 semi-hollow guitar, okay? Which I don't own. So I don't own a D'Angelico. I don't own an ES-335 style guitar, which is, that's what this is. So I don't own the style, I don't own the brand, and you know what? I love the graphics. I mean, this is the Grateful Dead graphic, and when you look at, like, the headstock, it's just so ornate. I think it just, you know, it really looks nice. It's, you know, a lot of times when you see a guitar like this, you know, it's like the Harley Davidson syndrome. It's like, you know, someone buys, like, a cruiser, it's like, looks like a Harley, it sounds like a Harley, but it's not a Harley. I didn't want something that looked like an ES-335 and sounded like an ES-335, but it's not an ES-335. This is its own thing, right? It's D'Angelico, which they're known for their, like, I don't know what you call this, you know, big body, semi-hollow, jazz box type of things, right? But they have a very nice headstock. I love the Grateful Dead artwork that's inlaid. Yeah, that's mother of pearl, I think. Let me see. Maybe it's a decal under the clear coat. It's actually hard to tell because it looks a little, let me see. No, I would say, no, it's definitely a mother of pearl, but it looks like there's a layer on top because it almost looks three-dimensional. And I don't know if you could see that in there. I spin that around a little bit, if you could kind of see what I'm referring to. But love the headstock, love the color, love the flame on the front and the back. And, you know, it's just an exciting guitar for $499. The street on this, a little out of tune, but not too bad. I mean, you know, almost there. And I think it looks great. You know? So, that is my Sweetwater unboxing. This is my Black Friday guitar. If you want one like this, I've said this in the past, great price, right? This is one of those, if you dig this sort of thing, if you don't have this brand, you don't have this style, jump on it while they have them, because I guarantee, listen, let's put it like this. Once these are gone, they're going to be gone. People are selling these guitars on Reverb for more than I paid for this brand new. Okay? So that's all I have for you. I want to wish you all a happy Thanksgiving. And Friday night, we're going to do a live show. Black Friday night, we're going to do a live show. And we are going to check this bad boy out live. Stay tuned. Leave it one of those. See you later.